About 65 million years ago, dinosaurs went extinct. And about 230 years ago, first dinosaur fossil was founded. And after this, scientists were very eager to know about these creatures as well as people. And one by one, many fossils were discovered and many mysteries related to their living style and their morphology was opened up. But one question has always been rounding in the mind of scientists. That is there any descendant left of dinosaurs in this modern world? Or their species were ruined up completely? So we just took up this mystery and picked up the list of most related species to dinosaurs. So to know about the descendants of dinosaurs and the similarity between these creatures, then watch this video till the end. So in this list, 5 animal species assumed to be the most related species to dinosaur. Well, dinosaur isn't a species name particularly, because there were 700 different types of dinosaur species. So these 5 animal groups are listed after analyzing 3 or 4 species. So let's look at the animal group firstly. Chicken, crocodile or alligator, sea turtle, birds and sharks. And these groups were named after analyzing the species named pterosaurs, Carolina butcher and theropods, as these are most known species to dinosaur. So after analyzing and researching their similarity, it was found that every animal group have some similarity of at least one group of dinosaur. But most similar pair is birds and theropods. Why? So birds are a group of warm-blooded vertebrates. They live worldwide and range in size from 5 cm hummingbird to 2.75 meter ostrich. There are about 10,000 living species of birds. Jumping to theropods, so theropods first appeared during the Carnian age of the late Triassic period, 231.4 million years ago. They are generally classed as a group of saurischian dinosaur, and they are characterized by hollow bones and three-toed limbs. And the evolution of birds are said to be from the suborder of theropods, named Silurosaurian theropods. Let's back to the question, why the birds are called descendants? So there are many similarity and evolution that was founded in both the species. So let's compare those similarities and evolution one by one. But before starting that, we tell you that there will be two pictures in which one is of Celurosaurian theropod and one is of Archaeopteryx. What Archaeopteryx? So Archaeopteryx was the oldest known bird which first appeared about 160 million years ago. And the reason why scientists took Archaeopteryx for comparison, so it was oldest known bird, and if birds are descendants, then Archaeopteryx should show more similarity than the modern bird. Let's take a look to those similarities. First is large orbits. Both Archaeopteryx and theropods had large eye orbits compared to their skull size. Second, bones. Both of them had thin walled bones. Foot structure. Both had 4 toes but supported by 3 main toes. Both Archaeopteryx and theropods had S-shaped curved neck. Both of them had teeth with a constriction between the root and the crown. And apart from this, researchers noticed some evolutions in Archaeopteryx that we can see as a difference between them. First, pubis. As the pubis of Archaeopteryx shifted from an anterior to more posterior orientation than that of theropods. Second, forelimbs. As both forelimbs and hind limbs lengthened, they became long enough to serve as an airfoil and evolved into wings. Pectoral girdles. As both of them have, but small changes in Archaeopteryx that benefited them to fly. And last, feathers. Small and possibly feathered dinosaurs were recently found in China, and many researchers claim that Celurosaurian had external covering that could be called protofeathers. So that's all are some similarities and evolution that indicates theropods were the ancestors of birds. And again I am saying that, if you are confused that there were some contrasting shapes in the skeletal structure of both of the animal, then there will be obviously. Because every animal have to go through the process of evolution, and it brings some changes in the morphology or anatomy of the animal. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if not, comment me some suggestions for improving myself. And if you like this video, then don't forget to hit subscribe and like button. Catch you later.